that I'll be blind. Here's some time to dig us down and shit my hat.
Oh, my controllers are fucking tired. Alright, give me a second here, folks. Which port is this? This should do it.
The devices, audio devices, all audio going to my headphones. Let's go. Are we ready to rumble, kids? Let's go. I don't think you're ready for this. I'm gonna knock you, I'm gonna knock you down. Ain't gonna bring no shame. Gonna bring you all the game. You can't make me, you can't bring me, you can't make me wanna go inside. Let's go. We ain't gonna make it flow. We gonna knock it down. We gonna knock your ass out. You ain't no shit, cause you ain't a fucking bitch. You think you can bring me, motherfucker. You can't even see me. Let's go, bitch. Let's go. You nothing but a hoe. Bitch, think you got shit. Man, in my neck, I'm gonna beat your ass, bitch. You just beat Machine Gun Kelly because you ain't done a lot, you fucking ugly ass and jelly.
Let's go, I'm on patrol.
Hey, eat your ass, Stewie. Give me the boy.
Just like that, it's third down. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Gonzalez. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down when his way it worked out.
It doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
On first down, Ryan. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll go down at the 28.
I we're just alone, they heaven's on before him, simply love and break your heart. The stars have pierced the sky, they left them all behind. Left to wonder why, left a song behind. Hey, miss my laughing out. Hey, miss my lucky round. Take my line. Whoa. And snappadoodles.
Incomplete.
There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
That good for six as they keep this drive right on rolling. Back to throw, Rodgers. And he finds his tight end, it's Ertz. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. A gain of six there on first. Now Rodgers. He's going to let it fly. And this results in six. Touchdown. Devontae Adams, 38 yards. And his guys are just an extra point away now from taking the lead in this game. A very important extra point there, up and good. And that is going to put him on top by a point, and it sets us up for quite a finish. This is taken at the three. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defense.
Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Keaton. And put it on the board. It's six, a touchdown. So much for the game-winning two-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well, and they end up picking that one off and sealing the deal for themselves.
This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they're working on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They call these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard. Brian to throw. Over the middle. That's caught by Ridley. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the defense. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. And they were hoping to get down there, get the score, and get this thing into overtime. How deflating.
Absolutely. I mean, let's face it, heartbreaking. They had an opportunity, had a chance, and probably were feeling pretty good about what was going on. And that was taken away from them by their own mistake.
Yep, the opportunity squashed. Now it's a giant. Breaks the tackle. Now an alley. And it's a touchdown. Jay and Jay. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
This will be taken in at the one. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Ryan. Now a desperation throw. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Barry Church. And they have the football. It will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel...
Ever since I left the city, I know when I'm blaming you. Mine right now. Ooh, gold premium pack. And it's gonna be loud. Ooh. Ooh, and you're still not better than my boy Hendrix. Ooh, Marshall Yanda. Look at that. Two Packers. That's hilarious. And Jabril Peppers. And you can sit your booty down.
What the fuck?
Hello.
Whoops.
Hello, hello, hello. Whoops. Wait, do I even have... Oh, boy. I just thought about something. She's gonna be mad. Oh, boy. Hello? How the fuck? Restart.
That's a beautiful play.
Say it was a little more better. to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando. I'm the coach, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. Coming up, we've got a good one on tap. Between the
team took good, solid fundamentals to win ball game. It's the same thing today. Stay focused. Get
ahead for the game. And on the offense, getting ready on second down. Second down, here's Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. That's Adams. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A really good pickup of 28 yards. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And an alley to run. Finds a seam inside the 40. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Throwing is Rodgers. Dancing to his left. 12 more yards there, and another first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I gotta give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. He needs to make those plays when the Lions go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. At this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. It's first and 10 from the 12.
Take them all.
back to throw. To the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds. The completion good for three, and it's second down. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. Got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Back to throw. That is caught at the seven. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Now Bradford. And it's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about.
Offside. Defense.
Oh, he's a linebacker.
Each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
So the ball's moved to about the one after the penalty. First and goal. Bradford. And he just throws his ball. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed, and that ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. Here's Bradford.
No, you're not.
He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. The Stork. Famer Ted Hendricks in there to drop it as the clock continues to roll. And this is going to be incomplete. Took their shot at going for the win, didn't get it. Now bring on the field goal unit, tie this thing.
It's the right call. I totally believe that. But if I'm on defense, I'm also staying a little loose here in case they want to be really aggressive and fake it.
Changed on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of what? A turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like. Like they're drawing them up in the dirt, and so far it's working for both of them.
Yes.
If my car's not ready, do you have a problem coming to get me? Because he's got to go to the grocery shop.
No. I just want to make fun of him for being a pansy and not driving his damn truck.
Well, his truck's a pain in the ass to drive. That's right.
Wimp.
Yes.
Wimp!
Yep, that's wimp.
Thank you. Okay, we get it. If you're not going to understand the joke I'm going with, then I don't want to hear you talk about death. I wasn't joking about that. I'm saying he, because he's an asshole, he's probably the one that had the disease in the beginning. Alright, I'm not even going to get the joke out, so fuck it. Yeah, fuck it up! Just shut up! Just shut up and eat! If you're not gonna listen, shut up and fill your mouth with something at least. God dang it. Nobody got a doodle day do.
Gets ready to rock. McCown to throw on second down. If he could have gotten the feet in, instead it's incomplete. Boy, that really could have turned this one upside down.
I think when they get back in the huddle, the question will be, why did you throw that one? The coverage was incredible all over him. The only thing he didn't do after he caught the ball as a defender was get his feet in bounds. That should have been a turnover.
Throwing is McCown on third down.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Now think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period where things just like this. They'll describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what we said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's our visitors with the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They find some open field here. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Right back to him on first down. And now running right through it. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. Great footwork, but still wrangled down before reaching the 20. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
And that last carry puts him right in the 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient. Followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Only a pickup of 2, but that's all they needed for the first.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Rob has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards, and he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Darren Lee there to get him down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments and doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
And this will be a touchdown. Jay Ajayi, 14 yards. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead. Perhaps a sigh of relief from the Madden Legends after that score.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. I don't think they expected to be challenged today. But if you're part of the Madden Legends, you're always going to be challenged by who's playing you.
Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. Now on the return. Oh, no. The ball is loose. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. They'll try to run with a drive. A nifty move on the run, but ultimately stopped short.
He wasn't listening.
Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Now they try the right side here. And he will have a touchdown. Jay Ajayi taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
One final try for McCown. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one.
Like certainly defensively. He's pretty good.
I can smell it.
It's good. Your cat can too because he's sitting on the floor in the kitchen.
Well, I have one.
Not
giving him my shrimp. He's gonna try one.
What's the harm of giving Digit one? He's been good for the last almost 2 weeks now.
He hasn't really attacked people for no fucking reason.
I got my best man. I got my best man. I got a
ever since I left the city.
My back will be party.
Ha ha ha, I'm eating you.
Ooh, 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 baby, ooh, 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 baby, baby, ooh, baby, baby.
Oh, baby, 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 James Devlin, boom, boom, Devlin. I'm gonna shoot you in the heaven. You're like Beyonce, pooty, pooty, tandy, bula, bula, bambi, bida, 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 bamba, Malcolm Jenkins, jing, 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 ding, 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 ding. Man, that girl did not listen to me.